Good afternoon, dear students. Today we will discuss experiment on centrifugal pump. Okay. So basically, we have two types of pumps. One is reciprocating, and another is centrifugal. Okay. So we'll discuss today about centrifugal pump. Okay. You can see the experimental setup. We have here the energy meter or the power input. With this, we can get the power input. So you have to count number of impulses in a given time. Okay. This will be giving us input power. So here we can note down the pump speed, means at what speed the impeller is rotating. Okay. Then here we have vacuum pressure gauge. Okay. This will give us gauge pressure reading. So this will give us gauge pressure reading. Then we have this delivery pressure gauge. Okay. Here we are noting down with respect to mm of Hg, and these are the specifications which we will be using in the calculations. Okay, so coming to this side, we have a motor here. Okay, when we switch on the power supply, motor starts running. So you can see here there is a shaft which is coupled with couplings. Okay, this makes the pump to rotate. So here we have a pump. This is a centrifugal pump. Okay, as the motor switches, as the motor is switched on. What happens is, okay, before that we do priming. So you can see over here there is a passage given, or there is a provision given for priming. Okay, why do we priming? Why we do priming is, if by chance if there is priming is not taken care of, if the priming is not done, because of air gap in the pipeline, the water may not be pushed, or water may not be water may not reach the overhead tank, or the pump may not work effectively. To avoid such problem, what we do, we try to eliminate the air gap or air bubbles in the pipeline so that the pump works satisfactorily. Okay, yes. So this is priming passage which is given here. So when we come close to the experimental setup, so this is the pump passage. This we can take it as center of the pump. Or impeller eye, it will be here. If you take a cut section, if you see it, there is impeller and there will be impeller eye. So the water will enter from the ground tank or sump tank. Okay, it will enter through this passage. It enters the eye of the impeller. Okay, so then water will be pushed outside, and the water gets stored in the overhead tank. This is the overhead tank. Okay, this is the overhead tank. So water gets stored over here. Okay. Now the terminology is what we will be using here is, so this is the center of the pump. From center of the pump to the ground tank water level, we have suction side or suction height or suction head. Okay. From center of the pump to the overhead tank water level, so we can take this, okay, approximately to the overhead tank water level. This is delivery side or delivery head. Okay, now how the pump works, this is important. So this we have to understand. When we switch on the pump, as the impeller starts rotating, because of centrifugal force, water will be pushed outside. So as the water will be pushed outside, it follows this passage, and water will move up and will come and get filled here. Okay, as there is no water at the eye of the impeller, there will be vacuum pressure created. Because of that, suction happens. Okay, and why it happens? At the eye of the impeller, the pressure will be say 0.1 or maybe negative pressure, minus say 0.5 bar or 0.1 bar, very less pressure at the eye of the impeller. But at the ground tank, the water pressure is 1 bar, which is atmospheric. So automatically or naturally, the water starts moving from higher pressure to a lower pressure. Naturally, so this is the water will be sucked because of vacuum pressure. So this is how a pump works. Initially, because of centrifugal force, water will be pushed outside. Because of that reason, at the eye of the impeller, we have vacuum pressure created. As the pressure difference between eye of the impeller and the ground or the sump water level, automatically water will be sucked, and this cycle repeats. So this is how a pump works. And okay, so we in the experiment we have to calculate the efficiency of the pump. Okay, in order to calculate efficiency of the pump, we need to find out output upon input. So output of the pump is to what height we are pumping the water. From ground level to what height we are pumping the water. So if you come to know the head, again switch the pump is working, and the quantity of water, the quantity of water which is being displaced from the ground to the overhead tank, it may be 1000 liter or 2000 liter. Based on these two parameters, we calculate output power using the formula rho q gh. Rho q gh. Output power is equal to rho q gh. Okay. Again, if I repeat, q will be the quantity of water displaced from the ground tank to the overhead tank, and h is the total height, which includes suction head and delivery head. So this is how we calculate output power, and as I told earlier, the input power will be calculated using energy meter. Okay, depending on how many impulses it will make for a given time. Okay, and this is how we conduct the experiment. And one more thing here is the manometer reading. This will give us the say, let's suppose for 10 centimeter rise in the water level in the tank, if you could note down the time, then you can find out the discharge. Then you can find out the discharge or velocity. So this will help us calculating the actual discharge. This will help us in calculating actual discharge. So this the scale fitted will help us in calculating actual discharge. So here in the lab, we take for every 10 centimeter rise of water level, what is the time taken? And the area of the tank is fixed, so we get to know the volume divided by time taken will give us actual discharge. Okay. And further, if you note down all the observations, so we can refer to the manual and you can do the all the calculations. Okay. So this is about the centrifugal pump experiment. Okay. Thank you.